Hey guys, welcome back here in the forest. At first, I have to say sorry to you. Last week there was no video, but I was sick and I couldn't go out. Yeah, I hope you can understand it. I think today it's time for a bit of macro photography again, because the last weeks I did bird photography, and here I think today I will do some macro photography, but I will don't photograph flowers. I will photograph some insects here in the forest, and I was here last week one time and I found so much insects. That was really nice, and a lot of spiders. There was everything full on the ground with little jumping spiders, and here maybe I can find them today again, but at first I want to show you some new gear I became to my birthday 2 weeks ago.
Okay guys, stop. I didn't became it, I got it to my birthday. I don't know what was going on in my head when I said this, but it was really stupid. I'm sorry.
Okay guys, my first and biggest gift was this photo backpack. I will don't show it you now. I will make a video about it, I think next week. So a little review, so be excited. And then I got this this macro extension rings here, this one, and this rings, and with this rings you can go closer to a motif, and that's quite really nice, because you don't have to buy a new expensive macro lens. Of course they are much better, and I think I will buy one in a few years, but for the beginning this is enough, and I think this macro extension rings costs about 40 euros, and I will link them in the description, and I think they're quite good. And yeah, now I will walk around a bit and look for some insects, and it's starting raining right now, but I think that doesn't matter. Yeah, I hope it will stop in a few minutes, and if not, yeah, I think it doesn't matter.
Okay guys, I only looked a few minutes now and I found this little snail, this little white snail here. I don't know if you can see it. And I think that's a really nice motif in the green moss here. And here I will test it out, and maybe I can take some nice photos.
Okay guys, that's not so easy, because the sharpness layer is really small, and I can't close the aperture too much, because here in the forest isn't so much light, and it's in the afternoon, so yeah, I only have an aperture from 4.5 and the ISO from 2000, and I can't close the aperture more, and that's quite really hard, because the sharpness layer is really small. And another thing, but I think that's not too much a problem in macro photography, if you have the extension rings on the camera, you can only focus, you can't focus endless. You have only a little focus layer I think about 10 centimeters and not more. Yeah. But now I will take photo from the snake. Otherwise, she's not here anymore. Guys, it's hard, but I think it pays off. Okay guys, that's really incredible. It's so nice how close you can go with the extension rings. I don't know what to say. How so often I think I say this in every single video. I don't know what to say. but yeah. Nature is amazing. Look at this. This little snail. I think this snail ate the moss. I'm not sure, but in the recordings it looked like this. But here I will show you the photos and videos I made from this little snail here in the moss. Now, enjoy it. Before you move on, I want to tell you that I decided to found an Instagram account, and yeah, I think I have the account now since 2 weeks, and yeah, I will post there some of my photos and sometimes some short videos, for example this one.
This is a work of
and yeah, I already posted something, some of my deer photos and some macro photos, so yeah, it would be really nice if you support me and check it out. I will link it in the description. So yeah, it would be really nice if you see us there. One tip I can give to you is, if you're walking around in a forest and you're looking and looking and looking for insects, and you can't find anything, look at some of this old trees. There are really often insects or beetles or something like that. You only have to go closer and look, and you're really often successful there. Guys, look what I found. This nice feather. I've no idea from which bird it is. If you know it, write it in the comments, but I have no idea. I will try to make a close-up photo from the feather. I think that can look nice. So yeah, I will try it. Oh my god, guys. Look at this. That's incredible. It looks really, really nice. And this photo too. I really like it. Oh my god. I think it was a good decision to try it out. And that's the best example for that you have to try some new stuff out. I think you can't get better if you only focus on one thing, and you have to be open for new things. I think that's really important, and you have to be spontaneous, because today I only wanted to photograph insects, but now I found this feather, and yeah, I think in nature photography the situation changes really, really fast and really often, and you have to be spontaneous.
Oh my god, guys, look at this. Oh my god, this insect here, I have no idea what it is. I just found it here on this tree stump, but I have no idea what it is. It looks so interesting. Have you any idea what it is? I think maybe it's a I don't know the English name, a larva. I have no idea. A larva of a mosquito, I think. Or yeah, I think it's that. But I'm not sure. If you know it, write it in the comments. It looks so interesting. Oh my god. That's definitely the highlight of the day. Yep, guys, it was a mosquito. She's now, I don't know the how it's called in English. but she's now a real mosquito. But I missed the moment. That's quite a bit annoying. But it is what it is. And it was so interesting to watch. Oh my god, I never saw this before. That's, oh my god, I can't believe it right now. But here, that's amazing.
Another really, really helpful tip and important tip I can give you is that you have to keep time. If you can't find insects or any animals, it's the same with birds or deer or but with every animal, with every wild animal. Then sit down before in the example in with insects, sit down before a stump, before a tree stump, and sit there 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and some time you find something. You can see some movements, or you find a snail or a beetle or something like that. And that's a really, really helpful tip, I think, and you have to try it out the next time when you're outside. A few minutes ago I showed you this feather I found, and now I found this place here, and here all on the ground everywhere feathers. Look at this. Here are some one, and here are some smaller one, and here's one. I think that was a fox that ate a bird. I'm not sure, but I think it was a fox. Here, I just wanted to show you this. And oh my god, there's a beetle in my lens. What the heck? That's not good. Now it's climbing in the lens. That's really not good. I don't know how this happened. So there's the glass of my lens, and behind this glass there's a beetle. Maybe I can show it you with my phone. There, can you see it? There, it's walking. I filmed this right now with my ESR. Here now it's walking in the lens. There it is. Can you see it? I have no idea how this happened, and I don't know what to do now. But I think I can do nothing, because here I can't take this beetle out of the lens. Here I have no idea what to do. I found a centipede right now in the moss, and I did something that normally is worst case or that you normally don't do in animal photography. I photographed from up, so from the bird perspective, and I think in this case that's the only photo composition that looks okay or good. I think not, it's not the best photo, but another perspective didn't look really nice, so I tried out to photograph from up to down. But yeah, you can write in the comments what you think about this photo. Do you like it? Okay guys, now it's getting darker and darker. I think it's sunset right now, and here in the forest the light is, there's too less light, so it's too dark to photograph. But I could take some other nice shots today, and I will show you these shots. And so there's videos and photos now. There was also a little dung beetle, and it was really nice. He climbed through the moss, and I could take amazing photos and videos. It was really, really nice to see, but I couldn't vlog in this moment, because this little insect was really, really fast. Maybe you can't believe it, but it was really fast, and it escaped under the leaves. So here I couldn't vlog, but I will show you this and some other recordings now. Okay guys, I think that was the end of the video. I think that was quite a good end. I hope you liked my photos and videos. If you like them, it would really, really nice if you subscribe my channel. That helps me always a lot and it doesn't cost anything for you. And maybe you can like this video. So yeah, see you next Saturday here on YouTube or maybe later on Instagram. So have a nice week. Bye.